TPAC is the leading research center for PPE in the country. We have test methods for evaluating the performance of protective gear to protect from hazards ranging from fire to chemicals to airborne particulates. We develop advanced test methods for measuring performance in new ways, and we also develop prototypes of gear for firefighters and responders and for the public. When the pandemic struck, we saw the need for a standard test method that would evaluate the whole face covering as worn. We think that there's an absolute need for a whole face cloth covering test method that would give a comprehensive evaluation, not only of the filtration of the particles through the material, but also the ability of the face covering to seal to the face, which gives you the full picture.
So with cloth masks or cloth face coverings, really what we're looking at there is there's really three main things that need to be tested and three main, performance characteristics you want to look at. One of those is filtration efficiency. If you pass it through that fabric, how many particles does that fabric actually stop? The next thing that you want to look at is breathability. The last one there that's most important is fit. If it doesn't fit, you can have, again, the best material possible. It can block everything in a material level test. But if you put it on your face, what's going to happen is the air you're breathing in is actually going to follow what we call a path of least resistance. We worked during the pandemic at our homes, some in here, and we're able to put together a couple tests to be able to just get a screening level using ambient air particles and trying to see how well the materials filter. We added an aerosol generator to give us a consistent level of particles at a consistent size. But doing it on our articulated head form allows us to get a measure of filtration efficiency as well as fit simultaneously, because we have that head form that I can actually breathe in and out. So if we can show people these masks actually work, one of the ways to do that is to visually show people. But we can shine the laser on the head and actually have it breathe or pump smoke through it. And so that's one of the things, is trying to understand how the particles move around the face mask, how they move through it. You know, we wanted to be able to develop a rating system. If you have a specification in place, you at least know that these have been through a process. Anytime what we work in the Textile Protection and Comfort Center, or we're working with firefighters, whatever it is, their personal protective equipment is the last line of defense. And so we want to do not just the face coverings or not just social distancing. They're all tools in the toolbox to help us get kind of control of this pandemic that we're in.